China aims to enhance ecological conservation and promote green and low-carbon development, according to a government work report submitted on Tuesday to the National Legislature for deliberation. According to the report, China will push forward with the green transformation of the industrial structure, the energy mix, the transportation sector, as well as urban and rural development. National lawmakers and political advisors have shared with us their thoughts on China's green transformation.
We also highly value this green industry because the high production capacity is itself green production.所以为了打造这个新的生产力啊，我们从两个角度来做。第一个呢，就对我们这个传统产业的这个绿色化升级，包括我们这个产品怎么做得更高效、更节能。另外一个就是我们这个产品呢，怎么做得更环保。
其实核电领域，因为我们核电不排放，或者排放很全产业链，我们从排放二氧化碳这个角度来说，核电就是一种完完全全的。清洁能源、核能发展领域的空间啊，从匹配我们国家的双碳目标实现问题、生态文明建设或者美丽中国建设相关领域，个人感觉就是接下来还有很大的这个发展的空间。
水满乡坐落在海南的最高峰五指山脚下，这个地方呢纬度比较低，海拔比较高，我们依托独特的自然环境。鼓励当地的群众种植大叶茶，通过种植茶叶，农民能获得增收。我们一直坚持以生态产业化和产业生态化为引领，协调好生态保护和农业发展、绿色发展的关系。
Observers in various countries have spoken positively about China's push for green and low-carbon development.
We are looking also at the measures China will take to for the greener, the greener of the economy, the greener of the country.
China's push towards greener economy is not only advancing its domestic technology and industry sectors, but also creating opportunities for international collaboration and investment. The expansion of China's green industries provides a fertile ground for global businesses to engage with.Benefit from this transition.
Well, I think these two sessions may create a good example, and it is also a period to formulate the new productive forces, technology, green industry. As a whole, it will create a positive impact in course of time.